Contrabands was a term that was applied to slaves who had escaped behind the Union lines during the Civil War. During the beginning of the war, thousands of slaves were rushing into Washington, and they were being placed on Capitol Hill and Camp Barker, where Logan Circle is today. But it became quickly a problem because there was a lot of overcrowding there and disease. So a Lieutenant Colonel Elias Green, who was the chief quartermaster for what was known as the Department of Washington at the time, had an idea. He looked out across the Potomac and saw that in Northern Virginia, there were abandoned lands that belonged to secessionists. Many of these secessionists fled the area at the beginning of the war. So Green recommended to his superiors that camps be established on these abandoned lands. The former slaves could go there and be in healthier country air, because at that time it was a rural area. So he thought, let's have them farm and we can pay them as well, and they can produce hay and corn and other crops for the Union Army. It was a way of transitioning these former slaves to economic self-sufficiency and conditions of freedom. Green selected some locations in Arlington and Fairfax where relatively prominent secessionists had lived before the war. There were five main camps that became government farms. Camp Springdale, which was actually on Robert E. Lee's estate in Arlington. Camp Todd, which was placed near where the Pentagon is today. Camp Rutger in the area of Falls Church. And Camp Wadsworth and Camp Beckwith in what the time was known as Lewinsville and Langley. Lewinsville and Langley today are McLean. The well-being of the camp was the responsibility primarily of the federal government, the Union Army in this case. But I don't think the Army, it appears, was as interested in educational activities in the camps. So that's where the private charitable organizations came in. The Friends Association for the Aid and Elevation of the Freedmen was one of the main groups operating in some of these camps in Northern Virginia. The Friends were instrumental in bringing education. We know about Camp Todd, which was near where the Pentagon is today. Emily Howland, a noted abolitionist, had a school there. Lydia Atkinson, who it turns out is the great-grandmother of Kevin Bacon, the actor, taught at Camp Wadsworth. So talk about 6 degrees of separation. Here we have only a couple degrees of separation. So children and adults as well went and went to school to learn how to read and write. The Friends Association also provided supplies. Dry goods, school supplies, clothing, blankets, those types of things. It's an interesting question as to the track record of these camps and how successful they were. It's hard to know completely how many people learned to read or write. I haven't come across records like that, or how many people felt a sense of self-worth or self-improvement because they were in these camps. But nevertheless, it was a step in the right direction. It was a step towards dealing with the consequences of the Civil War, of emancipation, and of integrating African Americans into American society, which hadn't yet really happened.